was fun, wasn't it? 20-0. Kind of gives you those old vibes and good memories of 77-0 back in 2003, huh? But that's football. This is softball here. It is the equivalent. It is. That was a monumental butt-whipping of epic proportions, and OU moves on to super regionals, where they have to travel all the way to their dorms or apartments, and they just kind of chill for the week while practicing, mind you. You know, you want to be good to go there. But they take care of regionals, no problem. Unlike there was one time in the past they had to go through a, you know, a loser's bracket, but none of that here. OU looked dominant. What was also important was they were able to get through this easily without the services of Jordy Ball. I'm sure everyone's going to be wondering if Jordy's going to be available for supers, but I'm going to lean towards no at the moment. And I know some people are wanting to have hope and things could change in a week, but from what I'm hearing right now, that's a no. So again, it could change, but from they're leaning towards holding her out potentially. So, but if that's the case, the way the bats are going right now, you may not need Jordy Ball. Jocelyn Alo was fantastic today. You know, nearly had two home runs, just went foul in that last one. But just to recap on what this team has done this year, 52-2 overall, 37 run rule wins. That was number 37. I'm 37. There's a Clerks reference for you. Let's see, 47 runs allowed all year. Pretty insane. 133 total home runs, 31 shutouts. And they're well on their way. Now, as of this moment, UCF is up 4-0 on Michigan. The Orlando Regionals, which are right down the street from me, have got a little bit delayed because of weather here. It's nasty weather in May in Orlando, kind of like Oklahoma gets nasty weather. We get it here too. But as of right now, UCF's looking good and they got the bases loaded, so it's not over yet, mind you, but it is looking likely that the Knights will be making a trip to Norman, Oklahoma this coming weekend. And Eric Lopez, you conniving, interloper, you sleeper cell agent. You've been planning this all along, haven't you, Eric? And right now, Eric is doing play-by-play for the Knights as I speak. And hopefully he's having a good time. But, unless something drastic happens and Michigan pulls a win and then has to win again later today because they come through the loser's bracket, we'll be seeing OU and UCF in the Supers this weekend. So, but again, just a fantastic job by this team overall. Not much else you can say other than, everyone's like doing their part. Nicole May had a good day. I know a lot of people some people are concerned about Nicole May. I don't even think she got to 60 pitches. So that helps a lot when you're just dominating and the pressure's off and you can just take care of business. Hope Troutwine had a good day the other day as well. So the combination of those two are going to be key to make a return trip to OKC, where they're probably going to have to get on a bus or something and travel 20 minutes up the road on 35. Ugh, actually have to travel a little bit. Just ridiculous if you ask me. But just a great, great, great weekend of softball. I've watched more softball this season, and especially in the regionals, than I have ever have, and it's been a lot of fun. I was pulling for UCF because it makes it interesting for me and the channel with Eric coming on. Now, there is a chance Eric might make the trip out to Norman, so we're still waiting to see on how that's going to turn out. But if he does, great. If not, we have to set up a little watch-along for this thing. Be very interesting. Be like a head-to-head super regional live stream watch along if that's going to happen. So we'll have to find out. Obviously, I don't know if it's going to be today or tomorrow, but I'm sure we'll have some news on that fairly quickly. So with that being said, congrats, ladies. Did a fantastic job. Another step towards another national championship. Super regionals in Norman next week. Got to wait and see if we get some ABC coverage like we did last time, huh? Because that was pretty cool last year, get national TV buzz. One of the big three channels or big four, whatever you want to call them, the big national, broadcast TV networks. It's always fun. But we shall wait and see where we go from there. Anyway, we'll see what we get some football news this week. Hopefully we'll get more time on kickoffs and channels and whatnot. So hopefully we'll have some news on UTEP and Kent State. That stuff should be coming pretty quickly in the next week or so. So looking forward to that. Anyway, you all have a good one. I'm going to get some dinner. Boomer Sooner. Catch y'all later.